thinking of the Cow Island project primarily as a scattered drawing. The elements of the drawing are going to be stone, wood, sod, and a lot of the existing elements throughout the space. I'll be working a great deal with attitudes that exist on the island already, attitudes that are made up of relationships of trees, of the climb to the top of the hill, of what you see once you get there, of little secluded areas on the island that you find when you walk down toward the water. And the drawing as it's done, when I say drawing, I'm really talking about a sculptural drawing. But the elements in these drawings hopefully are going to be things that on one hand might function as a table in one situation, a place to sit, as well as a sculptural element in the more academic sense. Two of the three had gang saws, and only one of those two had the African black. Otherwise, I would have had to use a stone, either a Canadian black or a stone from Pennsylvania, which isn't nearly as nice as this is the stone that I used. And the pink is the Salisbury pink from North Carolina. But this saw is an amazing thing.
And that's the shot. That's like
that's
liquid
water and steel shot.
And
right, and that's just runs this crack. And those teeth on that, I mean the blades on that saw could be set at any distance. So usually when they cut slabs for buildings, they can cut like 14 slabs, you know, out of one block. They can put in any number of blades, any spacing between it that they want.
Did you use your body for measurements at all? I mean, not just pacing, but did you often do that, to kind of, you know, that intuitive thing with the way two walls feel in relation to your body?
Yeah.
Is that part
out,
of
out
well?
Here, only in the sense of how the big square felt. In other words, when standing inside those strings, it became too big. I stopped being able to, like, really feel on it or in it.
The measurements occurred after a kind of visual feeling of
right. In other words, I would string something out, and when that felt right, that's when we would measure it. Like these stones were 18 feet, 2 inches, a big slab,
yeah, exactly.
And that's what it was in the string. And the same was true of the black line that was strung out. I mean, looked at over a period of a year. In different variations on that, the distance between them, and when that felt right, then we measured it. So that when I come in to set them, then I'll just set up my level, and I can, those will be like benchmarks for
me.
So that that'll probably be the quickest way when we're setting them. But.
Had the stone yards ever worked with artists before?
This place hadn't really, not on a scale like that. Plus, I mean, it's the thing that we found when we brought them back, the videotape. They'd never seen where their stones went when they left the yard. And just before Christmas, we got a bottle of Wild Turkey, and Alan brought in a rough edit, and we showed it to them. And I thought they would be much more interested in seeing themselves, but they weren't. They were much more interested in seeing where the stones went, and that, like, it never occurred to me that none of them had ever like seen when a truck pulled in and took out a shipment of stone.
That was it.
They never knew. That was the last time they saw it when it left there. And they never had that contact with what they were doing. The slabs were cut in the gang saw, and then the edges were cut on a wire saw, and that's just a twisted wire that carries an emery slurry within the wire. And again, the wire wears away and the stone wears away.
What's this guy doing here? Speaking of Edna?
That prevents it from chipping when the flame takes it.
The flame is temperature?
No, the flame takes off, it flakes the stone. No, the causeway was put in so that we could get materials across and the crane could get across. If I didn't put the causeway in, I would have needed a crane with a boom about 300 feet long, almost double what was there.
How many people do you think were, with all the
came
workers,
in contact
and,
with
the piece, with the project? I mean, is it 20 or is it 50 or?
Well, it's probably closer to 50.
Yeah.
Easily.
Maybe.
Yeah, between all the people at the park, the people in the stone yard, people driving the truck. Yeah, it's probably actually quite a bit more than 50 when you consider that, you know, the stone. Pink stone was quarried in North Carolina.
The quarry.
The black
the
was quarried in
see.
Africa. Yeah. The foundation under the all of the stones that were set was all crushed stone and sand, about 3 to 4 feet down, and then compacted.
People take it seriously? I mean, did they, you know, the crane operator or the...
I guess not seriously enough. See, that break occurred because it was pouring that day and the crane never should have been assembled in that kind of rain.
Didn't it drag the pin at all?
Yeah, but had it not been assembled like that, we would have noticed it.
Yeah.
I mean, that... You know, if that had been dragged more, it would have broken when it was going up right then. That's why we needed the causeway to move that across. The causeway was about 20 feet across. It was about 20 by what? 20 by, almost 20 by 20. That was very exciting when I lift it up.
Yeah. Gropius once made a statement about building very lightly on the land, sort of just lightly dropping things onto the land. Do you have a sense that that's what you did here? As opposed to imposing a structure onto the land.
It was real important to me that it be not imposed, and that it could be something that you dealt with or didn't deal with. But I don't think that as a piece that it really forces you to deal with it. I think a lot of people are on the island and do what they're doing on the island and may not deal with it. I think others, having no idea what it is, deal very much with it the way I had hoped people would deal with it. I've seen people come up there just out of the clear blue, and they'll go from element to element, and they'll cite every axis that I've talked about and come away from it. And that's really the way I wanted it dealt with. But one day I came up there, and there were a whole family, there. Weber barbecue up on top of the big slab. They had all their food laid out, and it's just a very convenient place to do what they were doing, and that's how they were using it.
Did this take a full day? How long did this particular process take?
The crane was there 2 days.
2 days.
If it hadn't broke, it probably could have been a day and a half. It probably would have been a day. The break doesn't look as big now.
Not at all. No, and not as obvious, because there's a certain kind of light there that's contrast.
The piece really came together when I realized the importance of the two trees at the top of the hill in relationship to the axis that runs right between them, that main axis that I've talked about. And I placed that square. That was the first element that found its place on the top of the island. And, using string to define a square that was maybe 20 feet, 22 feet, or 17 feet, or 18 and a half feet, visually and sort of sense-wise, physically, 18-2, which is what that is what felt good in relation to the space, in relation to the trees, in relation to being within the square. And after that was located, and I was sort of trying to understand how things would happen in relation to that, I determined that threshold. I determined a horizontal line laid in the ground before you got to those same two oak trees. And then all of a sudden I realized, just because of the way I was thinking of it, its lowness to the ground, that it was basically a threshold. It's just like a threshold going through a door. And then I really realized, maybe overboard, that lots of the spaces that I've been dealing with on all of the last sighted projects that I've done, the determination of spaces and how I'm always talking about, you know, you get this space ends here because that feels good. That whole notion of feels good is a very traditional, established thing that we're acquainted with in lots of situations. We're acquainted with it. And if we're sitting at a kitchen table talking, and there's a reason why people will sit around the kitchen table and talk much longer than around a specific dining room table and talk. And it just has to do with the comfort and with all of the things that recalls for us. So that big slab in the piece represents, in one sense, the kitchen table on the island. And on another hand, it represents a city square or something much bigger. And I've become, you know, especially at the time, I felt very convinced that these relationships could be magnified or taken down step by step, and they would exist in all of those things that we're intimate with. They exist within a house, they exist in the way a house works within a town, or the way a city square works within a larger space. When they're well resolved, they feel good as a space. And then, I mean, I'd never done that before, but in my head, I started to almost name some of these things that specifically as elements. That really shows the threshold before it was set in, and its relationship to the bridge. Piece is described primarily by three axes. The first axis is the one that has always exists, which from the bottom of the hill looking up goes straight up between two larger oak trees and down the other side. As you come up the island, the first thing that you cross is the threshold. And you go from the threshold between the two trees onto this large pink slab, which is a little over 18 feet square. You step off of that slab and you're walking down that same path that was always on the island between two parallel black lines of granite, which are about 55, 58 feet long. Another axis consists of a line which is drawn between
a black vertical element across the pink slab to a pink vertical element. It crosses that first axis on a diagonal. That's the axis that I originally wanted to work with. And that axis is now really only indicated by those two verticals. Third axis is described by a pair of steps to the right of the threshold and the pink vertical. The whole time that I was on the island, before anything was really pinned down, I wanted very much to make my main gesture of the piece run between what's now the black vertical and the pink vertical. And I spent a lot of time trying to establish a wall or something that would do that, constantly trying to deny that path that comes up and down the island, almost breaks the island right, cuts it right in half. And when that threshold and that center slab became established, I became very comfortable with the idea of using that axis which everybody has like walked on for years since anyone's been going to that island. And that became the main axis in the piece. The trees, the general lay of the land, the bridge which we're building, which will take you across the island, is all part of the total experience. So, you know, I don't consider the elements that I put in as more part of the piece than, let's say, those two oak trees at the top of the hill. I think that's a really important thing to understand, and that's what I meant when I was talking earlier about the difference of just being on the island and coming away with an experience of the project as opposed to going up on the island to just look at each element in relationship to each other